Well, welcome to the Boiling Point. We're going to take a break from our maintenance segment, and we're going to continue that on the next Boiling Point. But we're going to go out to the Boiler University, where Jeff Barto will talk a little bit about refractory and how it can be shocked.
Shocking refractory. If you have boiler rooms where there's a garage door right there at the boiler, so when it's 8 degrees outside and somebody's delivering the chemical drums, and you take and you throw open the garage door to bring the chemical drums in, if you pull that 8 degree air right in on that operating boiler, and the boiler decides to cycle at that time, shut off, go through post-purge, come on, go through pre-purge, sucking that 8 degree air in, you can shock the refractory with that. You can shock the boiler with that too, by the way, but you can shock the refractory too. So that's one way that you can shock a boiler without turning it on and off. Just, that's the way it is. The garage door's there, that's what we do. It just happens to be that cold. But we need to recognize that. Maybe we don't put that drum in there that day because it don't stay 8 degrees around here all the time. You may get that day or two, but we don't have, this isn't Fairbanks, Alaska or some garbage. So be aware of shocking refractory or the metal. Whenever you're doing refractory work, I did mention yesterday, probably the only place you'll see in our material, we recommend using wear services. If it's bigger than your fist and you have to patch it, the best advice is get somebody that does that to do it. No matter how hard you try, when you mix up the patching material, the texture that you get, you don't do that all the time. You may have only done it once or twice in your whole entire life. You're not going to get that right. Not because you're stupid, just because you don't do it. If you do it a bunch, then you kind of pretty well learn when you feel it, you got the texture about right to patch it with. And then what you'll do, and we tell you here, you know, you can take and V out a crack, use a screwdriver, take a brush, brush out the loose garbage, take a spray bottle and dampen down the area. Take your patch, put it on, take your spray bottle and spray your patch and just rub it till it's pretty well even. And you got it. As somebody that does that quite a bit, I'll tell you, you got a 50-50 chance when you fire that up that that thing don't get warm and pop. And it'll pop right back out, especially if it's a little damp, a little damper than you want. What'll happen, it's like anything that bakes, is the surface will dry out and get hard, but underneath it's still damp. What'll happen is as that heat transfers through that, just a little old drop of water in there. Once that heat gets there and heats that water up enough to flash into steam, that drop has a volume times 1600 when it flashes into steam. So what's going to happen is it's going to blow that patch out of there because there ain't enough room for that steam and that water and the patch stuff, okay? But that's how to do it if you want to do it. I prefer that you would have somebody else do it. If you patch a door and in the door, you're a little unsuccessful and the rascal runs for some period of time, you might have the crack up here. But what'll happen is the heat will go in there, it'll follow through the backside of that refractory, and the heat may exit down here in the corner of that door. Once you burn the metal up on that door, it's no good no more. Once you heat it up, you get it good red hot, then it's no good no more. So now you need a new door. You know, new doors are, they can be weeks away depending on manufacturer and which one it is. You ain't getting a door overnight. So you will be down. All because of saving $200-$300 having somebody come over and patch it. Or whatever it is. I shouldn't use a number, because if it's $500, I'll get an email. Hey, stupid, I called somebody in and they charged me $500 and you said $200-$300. where's my money at, you owe me? But forget the money. But a very small cost compared to being down and having to get another door.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that segment with Jeff Barto. He is an instructor for our Boiler University. If you haven't checked out our class or attended a class yet, make sure you just click right here and you can get some more information. And as always, you can check us out on social media. If you like our videos, please share them. And we'll see you next time on The Boiling Point.